Hi, I'm Tim from Scoop. UniFi is an exceedingly popular choice for small to medium, even large enterprise deployments. Although these units are plug and play for the most part, it doesn't necessarily guarantee optimal configuration. If you are using UniFi and have felt that it should be performing better or isn't roaming as well as you thought, take a look at these tips which could assist you to optimize your wireless network. The first thing to take a look at is channel use. It is true that UniFi APs will automatically do a spectral scan and select the clearest channel. This is not always accurate when powering on multiple APs at once. Laying out a manual frequency plan can yield more reliable results as you have complete control across your APs. You can get an overview of the spectrum by making use of the RF environment tool in the UniFi network application. This option can be found when clicking on a UAP in the Devices tab. In the window that opens on the right, go to the Inside sub-tab and under the RF Environment section is the option to start the scan. The scan will take a few minutes to analyze all channels in the 2.4 and 5 GHz spectrums. In these windows, you can see which channels are congested and can adjust your channel to make use of the least used spectrum. The best practice is to have at least 20 MHz or more of separation from adjacent frequencies. Alternatively, you could make use of the nightly channel optimization in the Wi-Fi settings menu. This allows UniFi to automatically scan and change each night in order to keep the UAPs on non-overlapping channels. However, be aware that this is the quietest time for RF interference and may not necessarily be optimal. By default, UniFi will make use of the channel width supported by the majority of connected devices, which may not always provide the best performance. You can increase channel width in two ways. The first is making use of global AP settings. Changing the channel settings here will affect all UAPs unless they are added into the exclusion list. If you would like more granular control, then adjusting them individually is also an option. Under the Settings sub-tab in the Radio section, you'll find the options to configure this. Channel width on 2.4 GHz can be set up to 40 MHz high throughput, while 5 GHz can be set up to 80 or 160 MHz very high throughput. Doing this can potentially increase the maximum attainable speed on wireless networks. Just bear in mind that in theory, using the widest channel possible does offer the best performance, but there is a greater risk of interference that could affect overall speeds. Most UniFis don't allow you to adapt the antenna. Adjusting the TX power setting directly affects your coverage, also known as cell size. If the signal strength is weak in certain areas, then increasing the TX power of the radios should resolve this problem. Although raising the transit power will allow for better range, be aware that it will cause more interference. This becomes more of a problem where multiple UAPs can hear each other's transmissions. By default, UniFi has this set to auto, which is the highest based on your country setting. You can confirm the exact amount of TX power in the device overview menu. For high density scenarios where there is more signal overlap between UAPs, we recommend reducing TX power. Too much overlap will reduce performance as clients won't always be connected to their closest UAP. Weaker signals utilize more airtime and reduce network performance in general. Use Wi-Fi Man to check what your signal levels are between access points to find the optimal power setting. The client devices are responsible for which frequency they connect to in a dual band Wi-Fi environment. Although this decision has gotten better with advances in Wi-Fi technology, there's always the possibility they could connect to the slower 2.4 GHz network. To assist with this decision, try out the band steering setting. You can choose between prefer 5 gig or balance equally across both Wi-Fi radios. Load balancing is useful for high density situations as it provides the best use of resources on the UAP. We would also recommend reducing the TX power of 2.4 GHz since it propagates further due to its longer wavelength. Having your signal match across both bands gives the clients the best chance of connecting to the higher performing radio. Receive signal strength indicators, or RSSI, measure your Wi-Fi signal in decibels. UniFi allows you to leverage this information to optimize roaming by ensuring clients are always connected to the UAP with the strongest signal. In the radio settings, you'll need to enable minimum RSSI and adjust the slider to what the weakest signal should be. In order to configure this correctly, we once again recommend Wi-Fi Man. It allows you to measure signal levels between adjacent UAPs and test roaming behaviors post-configuration. Be careful not to apply too much of a strict RSSI setting, as this will cause the clients to frequently disconnect. Enabling fast roaming under the Advanced section in the Wi-Fi settings will allow device handover to be more seamless. This is disabled by default as it's only really designed for real-time applications. For example, having an active VoIP or video call while moving through the building. It relies on the 802.11r protocol, so some older client devices may not support this feature. We hope you find some of these tips useful for fine-tuning your UniFi network. For more information, check out the links in the description. Give the video a like and subscribe to our channel for more content. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Tim from Scoop.